Good morning, dear students. Today, now we are going to learn about 9th standard social science, part 3, civics. First lesson, forms of government and democracy. First of all, you know about what is meant by government. The government means the group of people officially controls a country according to the law. So this is called government. At present, the world is comprised by 195 countries. So 195 countries are there in the world. All the world countries are following different forms of government. How it has been followed and developed, followed by the world countries. Now let us see one by one. The modern world preferred only the democracy. Now we'll see various forms of government. They are aristocracy, monarchy, autocracy, oligarchy, theocracy, democracy, and republic. Now, aristocracy. In this form of government, that power puts in the hands of some privileged group of people, which means a special rights of the people. Those who are having special rights to rule a country. So it is called aristocracy form of government. Example, United Kingdom and Spain. So they are following this kind of administration. Monarchy, which means single. In this form, all the power vested with one person. That person has all the power. A person who belongs to the single family rules the country. According to the law, from generation to generation. So it is generation wise administration. Here, the power inherited with family line. For example, Bhutan, Oman, Qatar. That they are following these kinds of monarchy types of government. And next, autocracy. All the power, the absolute power vested with one person. Example, North Korea, Saudi Arabia, following this kind of administration. And next, oligarchy. In this form of government run by a small number of people, such as wealthiest land owners and powerful military figures. This kind of administration government followed by the Soviet Union, China, North Korea, and then theocracy. In this form of government run by a priest who rules a country, the name of God. It means religious administration. Here, the power, supreme power vested with religious head. Example, Vatican country is following this kind of administration. Next, democracy. In the democracy system, power belongs to the people. Here, people can select their representatives through the votes by the political party basis. Who obtained the majority vote, they can form a government. Example, India, USA, France. They are following this kind of democratic form of government. And next, republic. In the republic form of government, here the government that is ruled by the people and they elect their officials. So here, a country that has an elected government and then elect a leader. Actually, the presidential form of government. So here India and Australia, they are following this republic form of administration or government. Now let us see details about the democracy. The meaning of democracy is basically the word derived from the two Greek word demos and kratos. Demos means the people and kratos means the power. So literal meaning of democracy is power to the people, which means the people who decide the institution and the law and regulations which will govern them and their land. According to Abraham Lincoln, former American president, he said in his famous definition of democracy, the democracy is a government of the people, by the people and for the people. So here in the democracy system, people allowed to select the representative through the vote, it periodically via election. So here the people can allowed to select their representative and they have the freedom to exercise their power of freedom to express their views and freedom to organize and freedom to protest. So here in this system, people, they are selecting representative either directly or indirectly. Now evolution of democracy. Before 2500 years, the democracy system has been followed in ancient Greece. The city states of ancient Greece in Vedic period also, the democracy system has been followed. Chanakya's Arthashastra tells us about the basic unit of the democratic system during the King Chandragupta Maurya in his period. They also followed the democratic system and also local administration. In the proper administration, even in ancient Tamil Nadu during the later Chola period, they followed the Kudavali system. It means to select the representative particular for the village administration. That Kudavali system as was notable and unique system was those stage in the Cholas period. Types of democracy. So there are two types of democracy. One is direct democracy and another one is indirect democracy. In direct democracy, in people can participate directly in the decision to making of the government. But the indirect democracy, the people cannot participate directly in the decision making of the government. Then who will participate? Behalf of the people representative, they can participate directly in decision making of the government. So here people exercise the power through the elected representatives. Now merits and demerits of the democracy. Merits. Here the democracy provide answerable and responsible government. Is here the government is for the people and the democracy system, and they by the people, all the welfare steps taken by the government to the people only. So here whatever the grievance of the people, how to solve the by the government. Here in this democracy system provide answerable government and responsible government, equality and fraternity. In front of the nations, everybody is equal, all the people of the country. There is no discrimination in the case of anything else. And people, they are binded with each other because they are under the one roof, and they feel like a brotherhood, and it create the responsibility among the people, and also it provide local self-government for them for proper administration of the country, and then it promotes standard of living of the people. Demerits of the government. Here sometimes it provide unstable government representatives, or the people are selecting representatives. Suppose the problems among the representatives, here it provide an unstable government, lack of interest and a delay of democratic process, and then delay of decision making of the government. Democracy in India. India is the largest democratic country in the world. So here people are given the power, and also people are given to voting rights, those who attain the age of 18, and they are eligible to vote. It based on adult suffrage. Here there is no discrimination providing the voting rights, and it based on the caste, creed, religion, gender and education. Here creed means a set of beliefs. In front of the nation, everybody are equal. So here only age is qualification of the vote. Election in India. India is a federal form of government. Here federal means one center and many states joined together, so it is called federal form of government. Here the general election are conducted by the Election Commission of India. It's situated in New Delhi. India is a parliamentary form of government, and it consisting of many representatives who makes laws to govern the country, and it has two houses. One is Lok Sabha, and it is called lower house, and another one is Rajya Sabha. It is called upper house. In this Lok Sabha, in this members are directly elected by the people, here who obtained the majority of Lok Sabha, appointed as a prime minister by the president of India. The Lok Sabha election conducted once in 4 years. Here in this Lok Sabha, two members are nominated by the president, those who belongs to the Anglo-Indian community. Here Rajya Sabha members are elected by elected college. It means selected members of state legislative assemblies of the state and then union territories of India. So these are the members consisting of electoral college. So these members are electing the Rajya Sabha members. So it is a permanent Sabha or permanent house. In the Rajya Sabha has 12 members were nominated by the president. Those who are who scholars of the subjects such as art, science, sports, literature and social service. The first election elections democratic in India. The first election of Lok Sabha held on October 25, 1951 to 21 February 1952. So here in this Lok Sabha election, Indian National Congress won the victories, and it forms a government during the time Jawaharlal Nehru became the Prime Minister of Democratic India. Major challenges to Indian democracy. Many challenges are there in democracy, and some of the challenges are very major. The major challenges is literacy, illiteracy. It makes many problems in the country because of the illiteracy. People cannot get the proper utilizations of the government, and the government implement on many policies and programs of the people. So the illiterate people, they are not acquiring the knowledge from the government. And then poverty. Many people are there below the poverty line. Poverty means the state of being poor. They are not utilizing the opportunities given by the government. So it lead to the poverty. So eradications of poverty. Here eradication means the complete destruction of something is a major challenges of the country. And then caste wise problem, religion wise problems, gender discrimination problems, and many problems are there bursting out in the country. So these are the problems have to be solved by the government. And next, corruption is a major problem in the democratic country. The corruption have to be removed from the country. And then political violence, it is also major problems of the country. And then bad elements in politics, it is also challenges of the country. What are the condition of the successful of democracy? The poor and illiterates, they have to give proper guidance by the government. What are the implement steps, and what are the welfare measures taken by the government? Everything go and teach for so the people. Conditions for the success of democracy in India. Poor and illiterate literate people enjoyed the goodness of the democracy. Whatever the welfare steps taken by the government, everything had to be reached to the poor and in illiterate people, and the elected members, they should not misuse their power, and should not public property, property wealth of the country. And the eradication of the social evils. What are the evils in the society? More obstacles in the country. All the obstacles and all the evils and dangers from the society have to be removed. And then press should be embraced. The press only carrying the opinion of the people from various places to places. And public should be cooperate with the government. Public should not create the problem, but they have to be obey the rules and regulations of the government. What is the responsible given to the people? The people have to release the responsible according to that. They have to move, and also they have to cooperate with the government and representatives. They should attend, and they should understand what is the fundamental rights given to them, and what are the duties given to them. According to the they have to move in the country. And then closely monitoring of the representatives. The representative activities are closely monitored by the people. And then there is must have strong opposition party. In this party only can correct the mistakes of the ruling party. Always opposition party watch the activities and the process of the ruling party, and immediately it will criticize the ruling party. Then only the ruling party can correct their mistakes and going correct path. Okay, students, questions with answers enclosed. it. So go through it. Thank you.